Hi there, I'm Erin Markland. How are you? Welcome to another back office tutorial. I am a senior director leader with Park Lane, and today's video is about our personal website in our back office. So I'm going to share my screen here. That was fast. It popped up so fast. So I'm sharing my screen, so hopefully you are seeing what I'm seeing. So I am logged into our Park Lane back office, and this is what I see when I first log in. And then I'm going to click on settings and then profile. So this is where I am going to be able to see my profile and my website content and where I can edit and save this information. So if you're brand new to Park Lane, you may have default information here or no information in these fields, and you probably do not have a photo. So I would recommend uploading a photo here and then saving the photo. I think having a photo where you can see your face clearly, so it's not, you know, really far away, and you're, you know, you can use a photo when you're with your kids or your family, but I think something close up that shows your face, it makes it personable, friendly, and these are your friends and family that are shopping with you, so they want to see your smiling face on the screen, and it also validates that they're in the right place, that they're shopping with you directly, and they're in the right link. And so upload a photo here, save it below. And then on the right side, you can put your display name, your email or phone if you'd like to have those on the site. And then your city, state, and then you can type in something here at the bottom in the About Me section. And so when you do that, you can click on the bottom here to save changes. So this is in your profile section over here on the left. So we're gonna go now to this middle section called site design. And in the site design, you can choose lots of different cover images that Park Lane has provided for us. So these are beautiful images. Some of them feature women wearing the jewelry. Some of them are flat lays or, like, you know, home displays and jewelry setups. So you can choose something that you'd like. I'm gonna choose, let's see, which one do I want? I'm gonna choose this one. I like these hands reaching for their jewelry. Okay, so I'm gonna choose that one. So I clicked on this little button below the image, and then you can scroll to the bottom. So this is where you're gonna find the site URL. So this is, the URL is your unique link. So some people might call it a unique link or a personal website or a personal link, or maybe they're even gonna call it a shopping link. So no matter what verbiage we use, we're talking about the same thing, and we're talking about this. So all of us Park Laners have the same front end of the link. That means that our link starts with myparklane.com/, and then after that is where we can create a unique, you know, end link. So for me, I use my full name. I do this because A, I use my full name on a lot of social media, and so I just wanted it to be consistent. I do think that it's nice to use something here that is easy to remember. So if your friends and family obviously know you and they know your name, or if you hand out a catalog or a business card and it shows your name, I think it makes sense to use your name here. If you do have a popular or well-known business name, or blog or something like that, you could use it here. That's up to you at your discretion, but just keep in mind something that is relatively shorter. It's easy to remember and easy to type. So if you're new to Park Lane, you might be seeing this on your screen and it might have a default. There might be like a jumbled random number in there or something. So you can type in whatever you'd like and it will tell you if it's available and if you can utilize that end part of the URL. So you can save changes at the bottom here when you choose it. And then we're going to go up to this section here to update our social media. And you can link your social media networks here on your personal website. So when you click here, you can choose which social networks you want to connect with people on, and you can put your end link for these networks here, as you can see on my screen. And like I mentioned earlier, I use my full name for most of, you know, all my business cards, for all my business stuff, for all my social media stuff, so I use that in my website link as well. And then once you put this in, you can save changes at the bottom. So once you do those three things, so we went to the profile, then we went to the site design, and then we went to social media, and you can update those things as often as you need to. And then you can go to the bottom here and click on view my website. So this is a way to test what you wrote to see what it looks like. And this is also what your friends and family are seeing. So when they click on the site to shop with you, this is what they're seeing. So the image back here, I actually clicked that image and I did not click save changes. So there you go. You have to click save changes when you do these things. So, but you can see on the back here that this is the default image or the image that you choose for your header in the back. You see the headshot. This is the name and the profile that I chose. So you can see my full name there. Now, most people, when they click on your link, they're mostly going to click right here on this Let's Go Shopping button. But if they don't and they keep scrolling, this is what they're going to see. So they're going to see lots of videos, pretty jewelry. And then at the bottom is where they're going to see the About section. So this is that part of the profile that you typed in a little ditty about yourself, right? A little, you know, paragraph. And then they're going to see your headshot again and then your social media networks there that they can click on. And then get in touch with me. They can fill something out and it emails to the email that's on record. So this is how you can kind of double check the site, how you personalized it. I'm actually, and this is totally impromptu, I'm going to go back to site design. I'm going to choose another image and save changes this time. Did we do it? Okay, let's do it. Save. Okay, I click that image, go back down to save changes. Okay, now I just want to show you, go back to the view website. Okay. Hey, look at that. Okay, so last time I didn't save changes. So, but this is hopefully a nice way of showing you where to click, where to go to see all of your website information, to personalize and find your link and your social media info. And again, keep in mind, you can change that at any time. So if you need to edit as you go, you can. So hopefully this was beneficial. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate it.